And we're back. Okay. So, anyway, we're going to have another marquee match. We're going to have Kisa against Gamer B. Gamer B on player two side, Kisa on player one. Button check is finished. No. Someone's asking if these are both Japanese. One is from Taiwan, one is from Japan. Gamer B really upgrading his playstyle as he goes along.
Absolutely.
And in the earlier rounds, he was very weak. Yep. I will admit. I mean, I was like, yo, this is free. I think I had him, right?
Right.
And then as time went by, he developed, he played, he started to understand his matchup. I am really shocked to see what he did against Cosby. I didn't expect it. I think he was in Cosby's bracket. I could be wrong. But I honestly didn't see it going that way. I thought Cosby had that for sure.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, so, you know, it's these guys adapt fast, you know, especially a talented player like Gamer B, you know?
Yeah, so here we go. Match is underway. We're going to have I'm thinking about the other match. We're going to have Kisa. Kisa off to a great start round. Getting his drinks. Yep. Not caring. Ooh. Yeah, Gamer B is going to have his work cut out for him. Good of him to stay in his space. Poke. He's trying to stay very, very safe. He knows that Shun is a very dangerous character.
Yep.
What do you feel? I mean, obviously, you know Shun in this matchup.
Sure.
What do you feel that Gamer B needs to do to actually get in on Shun and, you know, keep himself in the game?
The main thing you want to do for Shun is act like you're gonna fall for his tricks,
yeah,
and then, you know, punish him when you get the opportunity. A lot of the situations, I mean, they look like, oh, okay, it's my turn to attack, and it's just a trick to set you up for something. So
yeah, I see you do that a lot. Yeah. I like it.
So, I mean, yeah, that's just part of the game, and it's part of learning Shun. I mean, Shun, you got to like play differently, like you do differently against Taka, differently against Jean or whatnot. But, you know, I think Gamer B really needs to, like, not fall for the tricks and just try to, like, force a fundamental game as much as he can. You know, when they're up close and they play fundamentals, they're pretty much even. Then it's just guess versus guess rather than tricks.
I agree with you. And I admire Gamer B's patience right now. I mean, he's really – he's playing this basic game. He doesn't know exactly what to look for, but he's staying mid-range. Not too far where Shun can get any amount of drinks that he wants, but not too close where, you know, any mix-up poke can really, you know – knock him off this game. Great job so far. I mean, he can take this round, and he does it. So now
that's
Kisa's
two rounds up.
Yeah.
Two rounds up. Wow, he's got Kisa on the ropes.
Yeah, Gamer B is leveling up as fast as he can. I mean, he is used to high-level play. He plays Japan a lot. He knows what he has to pay attention to. Unfortunately, this is a different game, but we see that he has what it takes to adapt. So I really feel like he has an opportunity to do it. Good throw break there.
Yep.
Breaks that side throw. Goes to the loop, but jumps around.
Yeah, honestly, I'm a little bit surprised here. I mean, I thought Kisa would be doing better in this match.
He's
had so much experience, you know, and Gamer B is just, you know, putting the heat on him.
Yes, he is. Now, you know, as time went by, Gamer B really gave up some space control.
Yeah.
He needs to adjust that. See, that right there was the reason why he lost.
Exactly. This is what Gamer B wants to not do, is just sit there and just, you know, watch, you know, like a deer in headlights, you know, because that's when Shun is just going to take advantage.
And this is not where you want Kisa to be. 12 drinks under his belly? I mean, that's bad. And then, okay, stay in mid-range. I like it. That move right there takes one drink. He's going to stay in that mid-range, play what he has to do. Gets a circular for his trouble. Low sweep out. If his foot stance was switched, that would have been a wall splat into a very deadly combo. Fortunately, it didn't happen that way, but kudos to Gamer B for staying in there. I feel he needs to just stay in that mid-range like he was doing.
Absolutely. I mean, I think
the
best is starting distance, and, you know, just don't let him get far enough to drink.
Yeah,
you know, that's the trick, you know. I mean, you want to get him just in an uncomfortable range so he thinks he can run away, but he actually can't.
Yeah. And this is perfect. I mean, Shun with fences, I think it's rough.
So, you know, Gamer B right now, he's applying some really good pressure. I think he should just try to stay here as much as he can.
Yeah.
Watch out for that, obviously.
Yeah. I don't think he knew the wall was there.
Yeah.
I don't think he saw it. Oh, kept him with the circular. Oh, and that's for two drinks under his belt. Sorry. Okay, Kisa taking advantage of that mid-range now. He said, you know what, I'll play your range. So, I don't know, let's see if he's adapted to that range.
Yeah, I think he realized Gamer B has a problem with, like, a lot of these new moves. He doesn't know what's advantage, you know, so he's kind of, like, abusing the stances. Gamer B really has to, like, be careful of this. I'd probably, like, if I were him, probably try to use a mid-kick a lot more, you know, just to, like, you know, keep that distance.
I agree. Very strong sequence of defense right there from Gamer B, especially by that wall.
Absolutely. He's just waiting for his opportunity and trying to strike. You know, that's what you got to do.
And I respect him for staying in his face. I don't think he wanted a forward kick there. He just got caught dashing.
Right.
Maybe he just wanted a forward kick. That worked in Kisa's favor.
That was a nice fuzzy cho on there. Beautiful.
Oh, tries to get the low throw. Crouching Crow comes out. Up. Hey. And once again, we see Gamer B's back at the wall, and that is going to be the killer. It is 2-0. Gamer B getting figured out little by little, but there's an opportunity to get that adjustment and come back. So
yeah, he did a lot better in the first game. I mean, my recommendation to RVs, if possible, play a little different than you did earlier, and you know, just try to control the tempo more. It's obviously easier said than done, but you know, let's see what he can manage to do. See, this is what he was doing right there is probably more of what he should be doing.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, especially at this range, you notice. I mean, you don't see him going for much drinks. He's not forcing any kind of throws. He's trying to get what he can from that range and then, like, force a knockdown. And then if you can't see, that right there is not what you want. The moment Kisa got far enough, he went straight for the drink. The moment he's close enough, he's going for mix-up. He's going for something to poke you with.
Absolutely.
Now, we know the close-range game is not that strong, but close-range, he gets that. And that's why mid-range is perfect.
Yeah. The other thing that Gamer B should probably not do so much is always finish his strings. He's always finishing his strings. And what some people don't realize is, I mean, number one, it puts you at disadvantage, and then number two, if you don't finish your string, you create like a space in time for yourself to do something else, you know.
And they really have to respect that.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, nobody's going to press a button when there's a part of the string that knocks you down. So
you know, I really have to give a lot of kudos. Give Gamer B more time, he's going to get really solid in this
Absolutely.
Game. One month in, and his defense is ridiculous. He's really stretching this game out to the wire. He just doesn't know what to punish what with. And, I mean, honestly, Kisa's playing very strong. So, you know, what are you going to do in this situation?
Yeah. Kisa got him down probably about a second or third round. And, you know, it's pretty much been Kisa since. It's going to be like a pretty rough ride, but again, you know, just got to try to like get that mid-range and not let Shin get too many drinks.
Yeah, I think he's doing an excellent job right now. He managed to get a few drinks off. That magic number of 16 is when, unless I'm wrong, is when Shin opens up all his moves.
Well, gradually. I mean, he's already pretty nasty at about 8.
Hey, yeah, he's pretty nasty with all his moves. Oh, wow. And that mix-up is good. I mean, you saw that deep breath. Oh, my gosh. That was rough for Kisa. He managed to take it. Gamer B proud of himself. He actually stood a chance. I'm not going to act like that was an easy matchup, that he couldn't have taken. Very solid defense. His fuzzies were on point. He knew what to look for. He knew what to read. He just did not know how to.